What's up, everybody? Hello, and welcome back to another episode of the You're Not Done Yet podcast. Well, your purpose is just moments away, and I'm here to help you get here. Guys, I know I've been gone for like 2 weeks, but I'm back in between Mother's Day and just family coming in time for graduation. Just didn't really have a lot of time to do anything, but we're back. So all that matters is that we're back, right? Staying consistent. So this week, we are going to be talking about delayed but not denied. So there are going to be two parts to this subject. One part is going to be me discussing my story and my purpose behind delayed but not denied. And then I will be doing an interview with a special individual that will also be telling her story of delayed but not denied. So let's just hop right into it. So delayed but not denied has been in my spirit for a while. And when I think of delayed but not denied, it's more of God had me wait for a reason for something bigger to come along and come past, right? And in sharing my story of delayed but not denied, I remember back in 2018, I interviewed for an internship with the St. Louis Cardinals for a special events internship. And I remember that it took a lot to get there, you know, like catching flights and just having money. And, you know, luckily God worked everything out, right? But the crazy thing is I flew in from Jacksonville to St. Louis, stayed overnight, and I ended up, staying in a hotel. And then I ended up, you know, catching an Uber to the Cardinal Stadium and doing my interview. And in that interview, I would just say that it was a learning experience and it was a great experience for me. But I just remember those ladies being wowed by my interview, right? Asking them questions, and they said no one had never, you know, asked them any questions about their job, how they like it, et cetera, et cetera. And so I just thought for sure, right? I just thought for sure that I was going to get that internship. For sure I was going to get the internship. So fast forward maybe like a week or two later, I hear back from, you know, the HR person at the time, Tyra, and she told me, she just was like, I just want to let you know that you did really great in your interview. You did well. Like, you know, it's delayed but not denied. And the only reason why I didn't get that internship was because I wasn't a local of St. Louis. So they couldn't pay for, you know, relocation and things like that. So in my mind, I'm like, well, God, like, I went through all this trouble and I didn't get it. Okay, so not gonna lie to y'all, like that thing really, it took a hold on me. It affected me because of everything that I was going through at the time. Like, I need the big internship, like I need the big job, like I, you know what I mean, like I want to save face and I want to say that I've done something great within my 4 years of being at FAMU. But I just remember, like, okay, you know, it's cool. But it just, like I said, it just took a toll on me because I'm like, okay, God, well, if I went through all of that and I still didn't get it, then, you know, go on and give me something here. Give me something, give me something local. But after that experience, I just took it as a lesson and I just made sure that I put my best foot forward in everything that I did after that. And so, but after that, I was able to get an internship with this company, this HBCU blog, and the things that I wanted to do at that special events internship in St. Louis, I was able to do that within that same internship, you know, like walking red carpets, working red carpets, you know, helping planning events and, you know, being with the talent, et cetera, et cetera. And it was a life-changing experience. I wouldn't trade it for anything in the world. And so we fast forward to now. You're thinking like, okay, Andrea, like, okay, you told that story, but what's the deal? So when I think of delayed but not denied, I didn't get that position because there was something else bigger and better in store for me, right? I didn't get that position because God had something already planned on the other side. And I look at my life now as it's been a series of delays, but God isn't through with me yet. Right? I don't want you to think of your delay as punishment, right? I don't want you to think of your delay as something that God is trying to keep you from something that you want so bad. But you got to think about it. The thing that you want for yourself may not be the thing that God wants for you, right? And then I think about delay but not deny was when, like, I found out that I was pregnant, right? All the dreams that I had for myself, like moving to Atlanta, you know, making a name for myself and, you know, working in the entertainment industry. And God was like, yeah, I know. But I think, too, if I moved to Atlanta, what would my life be like? Right? Like, I wouldn't have my son. I don't think I would have this podcast. I think that I would be so busy in trying to make a name for myself that I wouldn't be so focused on what God has named for me. Right? I don't think that I would be as focused as I am now because my son gives me that drive and that motivation to keep going, to make it better. And you want to put your best foot forward in everything. And delay but not deny to me is a special saying. When the HR person from St. Louis told me that, you know, at the time I didn't want to hear it, right? But you think about the way that God works in your life, right? God delays you maybe in the position that you want, but you're not ready for it. Or he has a better position for you on the other side, right? God may delay you in your business because maybe you're going the direction that you want to go, but not the direction that God wants you to go, right? God delays you in relationships because you are so stuck on worshiping that person when you're not thinking about what God wants for you, right? You're not worshiping God. You're not building that relationship with God, right? And then delay but not denied is one of those things that is hard to hear, but we have to understand, right? People always tell, you know, things work out for a reason. Things are the way they are for a reason. It's the reason why things didn't work out or the reason why the thing didn't go the way that you wanted to. You were delayed, but you weren't denied because God still made it happen. So don't think of your delay, as I said, as God punishing you, because he isn't. He wants to get you ready and together for something bigger and greater. And I'm not gonna lie, I looked at delay like, Lord, I ain't gonna never get there, right? But I am walking in the way, in the tone, in what he wants me to walk, right? At the pace that he wants me to walk. And I get in this mode where I'm just like, God, why is it not happening now, Lord? It needs to happen now. But if it happens now, then what's gonna happen? Is it still gonna fulfill you when it does happen? Probably not. And so you have to take heed on why he's slowing you down. And I'm not gonna tell no story. Having a child, me personally, slowed me down tremendously. I wouldn't say that I was moving fast, but I wanted things to happen when I wanted them to happen. And being delayed but not denied does teach you a sense of patience. It teaches you a sense of waiting, right? We're always in this period of waiting. We're waiting on God to do this, waiting on God to do that. But when is he going to do it, right? He's gonna do it when it matters the most, when you need it the most. He's gonna perform that miracle when you need it the most. So don't be afraid to be delayed. Just look at it as God is trying to teach me something. He is trying to mold me in the direction that he wants me to go. And that's one thing that I am learning about being delayed. And the thing is, like, I know that God is not finished with me yet. I know that God has a lot of things in store for me and a lot of things that are on my path that I'm pretty sure that I will achieve. And I'm speaking and claiming that, hallelujah, real soon. But don't think of delayed but denied as your stopping point, right? Take that time to learn. Take that time to grow. Take that time to think about what it is that you want to do and what it is that you feel like God has planned for you. And like I always tell you, if you don't know what God has in store for you or what God sees for your life, start talking to Him. Start praying. Start. Sorry, guys. Part of being a mommy and working at the same time. But just take heed to why you are in delay. Okay? Take heed to why things aren't working out the way that you would like for them to work out. He's pausing it for a reason. He's delaying it for a reason, right? And in your time of delay, use that time to journal. Use that time to write. Like I said, use that time to seek out what it is that you need, right? I mean, God already knows what you need, but personally, emotionally, physically, mentally, like, what do you need in your moment of delay? And some things that work for me in my moment of delay, I grew closer to my family. Like, I'm already close with my family, but I grew closer, and especially my mom, just having a deep understanding for how she works with things and how she deals with delay, and, you know, just being and just praying and just staying faithful and knowing that God is going to work it out. The second thing I did, like I said, I took my time and I wrote. Like, I wrote my dreams and my visions, everything down. And I just like, okay, God, you know, just slid it. Here you go. And I took my time to be intentional with my thoughts, my words, and my prayers. And the biggest thing that I always say is that I just want to be intentional. I just want to be intentional. I want my words, my thoughts, my actions to be intentional. I want them to be like you. Because 9 times out of 10, there's always a testimony on the other side of you being delayed. Okay? It's something that you will be proud about and to speak about, because He delayed you for that particular reason. He delayed me because there was something that I needed to work on and some things that I needed to get right before He released me, right? Don't think of your delay as, oh my God, it's never gonna happen. It's never gonna happen. No, it's gonna happen when it's supposed to happen, right? Not when you think it's gonna happen, when God thinks that it's gonna happen. And I am in this state right now where I feel like I'm in a state of waiting, like everybody is. But I know that my waiting is something to be proud of. It's something to think about, because it's like, what can I be doing in my time of waiting that's gonna push me closer to what God wants for me, right? How do I get in alignment with what God works for me? And delay but not deny, 9 times out of 10 is like God saying, no, I gotta get you right back on that path, right? I gotta get you right back on that straight line before we move to your next blessing or your next calling or your next assignment, right? You have to understand that delay but not denied is gonna be what you make it, what you think of it, and how you use it, right? You can't be upset because God is sitting you down. You can't be mad, yo. You can't be mad because God is sitting you down. Or you can't be mad because God is getting ready to uproot you and take you somewhere else, right? Take you somewhere that's uncomfortable. Take you somewhere that's unknown, right? And I feel like that's the beauty in trusting and having faith in Him, right? Yeah, he slowed you down a little bit. Yeah, but something was already in the makings on the other side. But it's how you choose to, like I said, how you choose to embark on your delay is how it's gonna turn out, right? And delay but not deny. Some of us are afraid to walk in our purpose, or some of us are walking in our purpose, but we feel like it's not going or moving as fast as you want it to be, right? Each and every one of us has work to do in our purpose. Each and every one of us has work to do in our purpose. So even if you feel like it may take you a little bit longer than others, that's fine. But you were delayed but not denied, right? Keep that in your mind. You were delayed but not denied, right? God is never going to deny you. He's never going to deny you. Now, he ain't going to give you what you want. Now, he's not going to give you what you want. But, so sorry. He's going to give you what you need. I don't look at that as denial. I look at that as him knowing what's best for me, right? Your parents always knows what's best for you, right? How you had to earn your allowance, how you had to earn, you know, your weekends to go stay with your friends, or you know, whoever you may have, or you earned that time to go to the movies, things like that. So you have to continue to walk by faith and not by sight, and you have to be willing to meet your blessings halfway, right? Delay but not denied is you actually putting in the work and you showing God that even in this time, I'm going to trust you. Even if I don't understand what's going on, I'm going to trust you. Even though I want this job and this position so bad, I'm going to trust you. Even though I want this new house, I'm going to trust you. Your delay is part of your growth. It's a part of your testimony. And it's gonna either make or break you. You're gonna let your delay break you while you try to go figure it out. Go ahead. And you're gonna end up back at square one, doing the same thing over and over and over until you allow yourself to trust the process, right? My theme this week is just keep going and trusting the process. Even if you feel like you're not making an impact right now, you are. Even if you feel like things aren't going the way that you want them to, they're going the way that they're supposed to. Look at your delay as a blessing and stop stressing. Okay, I know that's easier said than done, but look at your delay as a blessing and stop stressing. Okay, I'm telling you, delay but not denied is God's way of saying, I got you. But do you trust me? I got you, but do you hear me? Right? I got you, but are you willing to go through this test that I'm going to take you through? Right? Delay but not denied is a test of your faith. It's a test of your strength and the test of your willingness to sit down, be still, be obedient. Right? And I'm going to close with this. Do not take your delay as punishment. Take your delay as something to learn from, grow from, and most importantly, love from, and tell your story. I hope you guys got something out of part one of Delayed But Not Denied. Okay, so like I said, part two is going to be coming out next week with a special guest who will be sharing their story about Delayed But Not Denied. So make sure that you guys are following us on Instagram at You're Not Done Yet Pod, and me, your host, Andrea B, on Instagram at It's Andrea B. But until next time, You're Not Done Yet Pod family, I'll holla.